And coming up right behind our fire engine here is Kids on Bikes. Kids on Bikes open to anyone with self-powered wheels. Many of our participants have been riding in the parade for many years, and of course some are fairly new to the Claremont tradition. Kids on Bikes. And here comes Uncle Sam down Indian Hill. Uncle Sam has good balance. And let's also put our hands together for the Girl Scouts and their color guard. And the Boy Scouts of America, Pack 408. Coming by now, it's the Grand Marshal for the 2013 Claremont 4th of July Parade, Chuck Freitas. God, I love that beautiful red fire. Beautiful car. And let us now welcome U.S. Congresswoman Judy Chu. Thank you. And now rolling down the street in a beautiful red truck is our honored citizen, Cal Hargrave, Jr.
Corey, you drive like your dad.
Gotta love this beautiful red Mustang. Years ago, I used to have a Mustang like that. Oh my goodness, that's beautiful. Mine wasn't nearly that nice, though. So. Let's put our hands together now for State Senator Carol Lou. And now rolling down Indian Hill in the big white truck is our honored community group, CERT, C-E-R-T, CERT. Community Emergency Response Team. And now rolling by our table, we've got Assembly Member Chris Holden. And next up, we welcome our Blue Ribbon Spirit Award winner, the Claremont Museum of Art. Well, don't look now, but here comes the Claremont City Council. Let's welcome Mayor Opani Nasiali, Mayor Pro Tem Joe Lyons, Corey Kaleke, Sam Pedraza, and Larry Schroeder. And right on the tails of our Claremont City Council is the City of Claremont Police Commission. And now we're excited to welcome our theme contest winner, Elaine Ulmer. This year's theme is Claremont Rocks the Fourth, and it was created by Claremont resident Elaine Ulmer. Her suggestion was picked by the Independence Day Committee from over 40 other entries. Elaine, way to go. And now we welcome our house decorating contest winners, Michael and Rita Salvato. And now we welcome Citrus College trustee Sue Keith and superintendent Dr. Perry. Sue Keith is representing Claremont on the Citrus College District Governing Board and accompanied by Dr. Geraldine Perry. Welcome. Welcome the CUSD School Board and Superintendent, James Elasser. Put our hands together for the CUSD Classified Employee of the Year, Roberta Mercer. Oh, you know what? I think I skipped one here. Let's not forget our CUSD Teacher of the Year, Terry Keegan. Way to go, Terry. I got a bit ahead of myself there. And here's Roberta Mercer, our CUSD Classified Employee of the Year. And of course, put your hands together for the Claremont High School Marching Band. Right behind the marching band is El Roble Cheer. And next up, cruising down Indian Hill, we've got our Claremont High School cheer. And next up, we have the Democratic Club of Claremont and their theme, Democrats Rock. And now headed towards our table here, we've got the UCC Early Childhood Center. And next up, we're excited to welcome the Pitzer College International Program, the Chung Sin High School American Study Tour. For 23 years running, Chung Sin High School from Taiwan has been sending students to Pitzer College Summer Program for an intensive language and cultural immersion. Let's give them a big welcome. And next up, we welcome Pomona College. Pomona College rocks the fourth. And looks like Elvis is back in the house.
Look at it like it's going to kill Dave.
And followed close behind from the Rembrandt Club, part of Pomona College, founded in 1905 to support the arts in Claremont, the Rembrandt Club of Pomona College. Sponsors some monthly lectures and teas, excursions to area museums and collections, and a variety of fundraiser events. The Rembrandt Club. And next up, we got the City of Claremont Park Rangers. And I think Smokey the Bear is making an appearance too. Wow. Smokey's wearing jeans. And next up, let's welcome to Claremont High School Alumni Society. It's going to be an all-alumni reunion on October the 19th. And next up, we welcome the American Legion, Keith Powell, post 78. And the 1942 Army Chief. Right now, let's put our hands together for the Friends of the Bernard Biological Field Station. Carrying signs showing native plants and animals to our area. And here they come in their beautiful costumes, the Carousel Kids. And a spoonful of supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. I can't believe I got that out just once. Next up, we have the University Club of Claremont and their 1948 Willys Jeepster Convertible. And following close behind is the California Youth Spirit Corps, sponsored by the City of Glendora and the San Gabriel Valley YWCA. Love those spray bottles there. Yeah, those girls got it good. And next up, let's welcome the Schlick family close. And next up, we welcome California Faith for Equality. And their theme is marriage equality. And following close behind is the Claremont Little League 2013 All-Stars. Baseball players and their coaches, congratulations. And next up, let's welcome the marching band of the Claremont Irregulars. And next up, let's welcome today the Daughters of the American Revolution. And next up, we welcome our friends from Claremont Manor, rocking to the oldies. And next up, we welcome our friend from Pilgrim Place and the Mayflower. The Mayflower set sail from Plymouth Rock to Claremont Park. And right behind them, we've got Pilgrim Place, the Pilgrim Pickers and Peace Vigil Committee. And also right behind, let's welcome Occupy Claremont. And next up, we welcome from Mount San Antonio Gardens, Still Going Strong.
All the people from back to the
saw a gang of them in Claremont the other day.
By a little bit. 5 years.
You
gotta show them.
I get those color socks. I haven't found those color socks.
And next up, the Grable Gesselman family. Checkers and chess, Claremont's rocking horses. Checkers and chess riding in the back of the golf cart, which has been rebuilt to duplicate a 1915 Model T4.
Is that the guy who lives up in California building the rocking horses?
And right behind our friends from Habitat for Humanity from Pomona Valley. And next up in the light blue shirts, let's welcome CHERP, C-H-E-R-P, CHERP, volunteers educating our community on the benefits of energy efficiency with the goal of retrofitting 1,300 homes. Next up, we welcome Rancho Santa Ana Botanic Garden. Rancho Santa Ana Botanic Garden rocks native plants. And they've got their soul friends. And next up, let's welcome the fine folks of Granite Creek Community Church. And their float, it features an actual flag flown over a U.S. command post in Iraq during wartime in honor of the U.S. Army, Vietnam veteran, and Purple Heart recipient, Ralph Philip Riley, who's the father of church member Kim Robles. Thank you. And next up, the Claremont School of Theater Arts. And next up, we have the 2013 All-Star Teams of Claremont Fast Pitch. Can hear him coming right now. It's the El Roble cheerleading team. And next up, we welcome the folks from the Claremont Presbyterian Church. One campus, many ministries. And right now, the Claremont AYSO select team. It's the best on the soccer field. And next in line, boy, you talk about a feast for the eyes, the 1936 Packard Coupe, driven by Marshall Sirkin of Claremont. And next up, we welcome the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. And they say loyalty to our homeland is part of our faith. We are Muslims showing our loyalty to this great nation of the United States of America. And it looks like Uncle Sam is making his way down the street once again. Let's welcome the School of Arts and Enterprise Charter High School. Yeah. And we're getting close to the conclusion here, folks. Next up, we got the Middle Land Chan Monastery. Members of the team will use walking, meditation, and chants to introduce Middle Land Chan Monastery and its free meditation classes. And let's now welcome El Roble Hip Hop. And finally, let's give it up for our Claremont Place Senior Living. And our Claremont Place Seniors.